all-time bike for 2021. The frame is an Elves Vanyar. I've done an unboxing video about it, but I thought it's about time to do an actual video about the whole frame. So the frame itself is size medium. It's got a 49cm seat tube, 51cm top tube. It's a really good frame in my opinion. Seems stiff for me. Obviously I'm not doing mad watts, but cannot complain. Weight is about 850 grams. That's painted with mech hangers and all the rest on it. But yeah, all in all, I think a really good frame. And super light for the cost. I mean, so you can get it from AliExpress for about £850. So really would recommend. Going on to the next thing that makes this bike super light, which is the wheels. They're D-Robust wheels. They're about a kilo, a little bit over a kilo for the pair in tubulars. Again, they're not aero at all. They're just lightweight. And I think, to be honest, they seem good for me. I mean, like, I haven't really noticed any difference in terms of like stiffness with any other wheels I've ever ridden. And the braking, yeah, it's decent. I mean, it's carbon rims, but you know, I did get down winnets on them and they were okay. So for that, I'd say decent set of wheels. Again, like 400 quid for a kilo of wheels, it's just, you just can't really complain. Then moving on to the saddle and seat post, dodgy AliExpress saddle, about 60, 80 grams or something for 20 quid, cannot complain. Comfort wise, it is what it is. It's a carbon saddle. And then seat post again, AliExpress, 127 grams, something stupid. Again, a seat post, like, I don't think there's any point spending loads of money on it. Then moving on to the brakes, these are KCNC CB9 brakes. Again, not outrageous in terms of braking quality, but quite light, about 200 grams. So yeah, again, decent saving to be had. And brakes, maybe a Durace is about 300, 350. So again, can't complain. Then moving on to more niche things, pedals. You probably didn't think about them, but time pedals, or they're fake time pedals from AliExpress, a lot lighter. So maybe a standard Shimano Ultegra is like 250 grams. These are 140 grams, 155, I think, actually. So easy 100 gram savings, and it all adds up. Moving on to the handlebars. Now, these are the dodgiest piece of equipment I have. Straight from AliExpress, 250 grams for the integrated bar and step. Yeah, I wouldn't recommend getting them, I'm not gonna lie. I think it was a big error at the time because they're not very stiff and they just feel a bit noodly. So in hindsight, it's a bad purchase, but it is what it is. In terms of bar tape, again, take that off, say it's 40 grams. Take the hoods, levers off as well, another like 40 grams or so save. And it all really adds up. And that's the thing with building a lightweight bike. It's not really like about necessarily every like one component that saves a lot. The only real component that saves a lot is the wheels. Like that's an easy 600 gram save. It's all the small things. So then moving on, we've got like a cassette. This is a ZTTO cassette, again from AliExpress. It's 220 grams from 1132. And for like reference, a 105 cassette is maybe 300 grams. So it's another 80 grams save. And then we've got the tires, coarser speeds, the fastest tires around really. You could go lighter, you could go track tires, but at the end of the day, doing track tires doesn't make sense because they've got no grip in the wet, and if you puncture, it's just too much faff. So coarser speeds are good. Then we've got the info crank, the heaviest thing on my bike by a long way. It's really heavy piece of equipment, but it does the job, and the data quality is really good. I might want to change it in the future, but at the moment, it's annoying because it's like 200 to 300 grams heavier than like the lightest crankset available. So that would turn this bike a lot lighter. In addition, we've got a SN Vitai bottom bracket. It's a one-piece design. It spins really, really nice, my bike. And that is about it. Got a 3D printed mount as well for my Wahoo. Save some weight, and then we've got some dodgy cables as well, which it is what it is. So anyway, that's my bike summed up. Now we've got to go and get the scales out, give it away, and see how much this thing weighs. Right, I'm just gonna zero it. And there we have it, 5.8 kilos, basically 5.8 on the dot. So not bad, considering didn't really pay too much for any of the components. It was all quite a cheap build. And obviously I forgot to mention, it's ETAP, very light group set. Not the lightest, is SRAM mechanical, but it does the job. I quite like the shifting on the rear. And it's also one by specific now. So one last marginal gain is the wax chain, which I do myself. And if you're interested in getting a wax chain, then just message me and there's a link below. It saves potentially 1 to 1.5% of your total power output. So on a hill climb, that's quite a lot. In addition, when it's like really high torque, it will also save more power than a lower torque, which obviously obviously for a hill climb, doing a lot of high torque, lower cadence, and it's a Durace chain, fastest chain around. It'd be rude to go for anything else. So anyway, that's my bike. Hope you enjoyed watching, and we'll see you in the next one.